2024 was clearly the year of AI, and Ubiquiti came out swinging with incredible AI features such as facial and license plate recognition. Unfortunately, many of their older cameras, as well as the on-vif cameras that they now have support for, were left in the dust. Not anymore. This is the brand new AI port, which is a device that I'll show you in a moment that's designed to AI-ify all of your non-AI cameras. Yes, I came up with that word AI-ify myself. Not official Ubiquiti branding. Let's get it open. Real quick unboxing, as usual. You start with the installation guide inside. Here is the AI port itself. Slightly larger than the display cast, it has two Ethernet ports on top, one for in, one for out, because this is also a PoE injector. It's capable of outputting up to 25.5 watts if you're feeding it with a PoE++ plug, as well as a microSD card for edge recording, just like the new AI turret camera, which we'll get to talking about in a little bit. Setup for this is simple and quick. You plug your PoE-powered Ethernet into the PoE port on the device. You get a little light that shows up on the face of the unit, as well as the blinking network lights on top. And then, if you are powering a camera with it, you put your second plug in the top, and then plug your older generation camera directly into the AI port. Now, there's a few ways that this works. You don't need to have this in line, meaning between the network and your camera. All you have to do is simply plug it in to the network, anywhere on the network, and then in the settings dashboard in Protect, you assign it to which camera you want to bring AI features to. You can also have it in line if you want to use this as PoE to power the camera, and that's designed to give you flexibility of where you're positioning this device. Now, to cover this at the beginning, one critical thing to note that changes the whole conversation is that at launch, this was announced to be one-to-one. One AI port to one old-school camera, and you can bring AI features to this device. That is no longer the case. Ubiquiti has confirmed that in a future update, this single AI port will be able to support up to 5 Ubiquiti cameras, non-AI, of course, because it's not compatible with the AI cameras for obvious reasons, or up to 2K UniFi compatible cameras, or 3 HD UniFi cameras at a time. This is a game changer for folks with older Ubiquiti cameras that don't have AI features and want to be able to bring their still operational cameras online and give them facial recognition and other AI feature sets. To be able to do 5 at a time instead of 1-to-1 makes this a very attractive solution instead of replacing the entire fleet of cameras and instead being able to replace them over time as they die. This is also critical for older companies, such as small businesses, that have your typical off-the-shelf Chinese brand, Costco-type camera systems. You're going to be able to bring those on board with 3 or 2 of them at a time for this, depending on the quality of your camera. Additionally, at launch, the SD card for edge recording is not functional, but will be turned on in a future update coming soon, so stay tuned for that. One last point is that you cannot mix and match Ubiquiti cameras and on-vif cameras. You need to have one of these for the Ubiquiti cameras and then another one for the on-vif cameras. The on-vif stay on theirs and the Ubiquiti ones stay on theirs. The AI port is capable of detecting motion, people, vehicles, animals, and speech, and can classify vehicle type and color, as well as face and license plate recognition. This does work with the G4 and G5 PTZ cameras, which I will show you in a moment, and even supports, this is something I saw asked about in YouTube comments all over the place, the PTZ controls for on-vif supported PTZ cameras. Quickly show you the rest of what's in the box. Like normal, you have your Ubiquiti mounting template, regulatory materials, mounting screws package, a wall mount, which makes this super handy if you want to have it deployed next to the camera, and similarly to the display port, screws into the wall and then just clips onto the unit, which is rather easy to pop in and pop out to remove it. Lastly, in here are 2 color matched zip ties that match the color of the unit. Let's jump over to Protect and get this thing configured. All right, now you can see that I've got the AI port online and adopted in Protect. Over in the settings here, you have what camera it is paired to, which I'll show you how to do in a second. It's online, it's excellent. It's connected to a USW ProMax 48 port PoE. It's the AI port, obviously, the device version, MAC address, IP address, uptime, all standard fare for anybody who has used Ubiquiti Protect before. Over in the settings, you have the ability to change its names, locate, restart, and remove. Now, one thing to notice is that you've got the AI symbol over here on my G5 PTZ, and the reason is because that is what is assigned to the AI port, and it also says over here AI enhanced by AI port. If we go into the AI port settings and we hit manage under paired camera, you'll see the option of which camera you want to attach it to. In this case, I'm going to switch it to the G5 Flex, which also happens to be plugged directly into the AI port itself. And when you unassign it from another camera, in this case, the G5 PTZ, it does restart the camera in that unassigning process. One important thing to note, and I screwed this up in the beginning, is when you set this up for the first time and you assign it to a camera, make sure that you go down and edit the video detection types. You want to make sure to now assign face and license plate in there so that it does automatically create those detection types in there. Otherwise, you're just going to have a $200 device doing absolutely nothing, and that would just be pointless. So make sure that you turn that on. Now we have the G5 Flex, it's been assigned, and we'll jump over to the detections for not the G5 PTZ, but for the Flex. All right, and you can see this one was from before, but it did find my face on the camera, making a very goofy expression.
The AI port costs $199 and is available today. If this video was helpful to you, I would appreciate if you made your purchase using my affiliate link in the description down below. Subscribe for more videos like this, and thanks for watching.